Hey everybody, it's Josh with Resort TV One, and I am here at the Wyndham Orlando Resort here on International Drive, and I'm going to give you a little walking tour of the resort, show you the pools, the beautiful grounds, and pretty much everything there is to know about this resort that is located so close to Universal Studios and just minutes from Walt Disney World. So, hope you enjoy the video. Also, before we get too far into the video, I wanted to thank Wyndham for hosting us out here at the resort. They invited us out, gave us a couple nights to stay and check out the resort. So we definitely want to thank them for that. And here's a little sneak preview of what you're going to see later in the video. The grounds of this resort are so amazing. So I wanted to give you a little sneak preview of that and thank Wyndham. And also, if you'd like to book a trip here, there is a link in the description where you can get 20% off using the link that they gave us. So they'll know that we sent you over. So go check out that link in the description and you can book your trip to this amazing resort. So let's continue with the tour. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to hit that red subscribe button right below the video. Also hit the notification bell and turn it to all notifications so that you get notified every time we go live or have a new video. And finally, be sure to follow us on social media. We're Resort TV One on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. So let's get started with this tour. You can see this really big building over here actually is the convention center. They have a really large convention center. Not really having conventions right now, of course, due to COVID, but a lot of big ballrooms and things. And then you can see already the rooms kind of start and expand all the way around. The grounds here are expansive, and it's crazy because it's on International Drive, which we're going to show you a little bit later on a live stream. And actually, this is a really big piece of real estate on International Drive. So it is kind of crazy that it's so close to a lot of things like the Icon Park and all kinds of attractions on International Drive, but yet it's such a huge resort. So let's go inside and take a look around. So we're gonna head on inside the main lobby here. You can see the check-in area and a little bar here. I'm gonna do short clips in here just to avoid the copyright music, but it's a really nice bar and lounge here just to hang out and relax inside, wait for your room to be ready, whatever the case may be. Now, of course, because of COVID, there's not as much going on here as normal, but we do have the concierge desk here where they can help you out. But right now it looks like they're doing most of that at the main check-in desk, which was right there as I was walking in. And they also have a couple real nice computers here that you can check email or do whatever you need to do as you come in. And you can see here they've got directional signs going to the different ballrooms and the Cooper's Hawk Winery and Restaurant down here. We won't go very far down here, but this is just the convention area. So this goes way, way down here. Must host some pretty decent sized conventions here at some point, because you can see it goes down there. There's several ballrooms in that direction, and of course several around the corner as well. And you can see here, of course, there are no meetings scheduled. Well, let's head back out into the main grounds of the resort. It's really well landscaped, and like I said, it's very expansive. I was really surprised when I got here about how big this resort is. You can even see they've got social distancing markers on the ground, which is good. So we'll head out the back door here and check out the grounds. See, it's a really beautiful day today, so we got lucky on that. Can show you this awesome resort this way. But let's take a look over here. It's a really nice outdoor eating area. I think some of these are open for dinner. This is more of just a lounge, but I think that goes with this bar right here. And I wonder if they serve food or if it's just more of a place. This would be nice at conventions and stuff. If you've ever been to conventions, you know, between sessions or at lunch or whenever, you know, you come out here on your downtime and kind of relax and hang out with the rest of the people attending your conventions. So, and a lot of nice places to stroll around out here. Of course, that's another resort over there. But again, you can see as we walk out here just how expansive these grounds are. It's really incredible. You can also see something else. Look at this. that is the Orlando Eye and the Orlando Star Flyer. You can see the swings over there going down. Those go up to about 400 feet, I believe. So that's how close we are to the Icon Park. You can really see it from in the resort here. A little restaurant over here. We'll check that out here in just a minute. But here is a map of the grounds. And you can see all along International Drive, there are several restaurants, Longhorn, Red Robin, different things. BJ's, here's a Walgreens. And there is the conference center, which we were just walking through a minute ago. That's the lobby. We are right here. And you can actually see, we'll walk through here, the lagoon really wraps around this entire area here. So really cool to check that out. But this is Gatorville over here, apparently. So we're gonna go check that out. You can get a little better view of the icons there. It's a really nice bar here. I like the little paddle wheel fans here, little boats up here. So that's pretty neat. I think I forgot. They have a couple different pools here. Let's check those out here real quick. We're gonna take really short clips here with the music, but so here's one, not too crowded. There's a recreation and fitness center over here. Check that out here in a minute. So really nice pool area. Not a big pool, but there's another one right next to it. So we'll check that out. So this is actually the other pool, and it actually looks a lot bigger than the one over there. So that's actually pretty interesting. And again, we'll keep the clip short, but you get an idea there. You don't want to get too close and freak people out when they're in the pool. I'm just trying to give a little tour here, but not invade anybody's privacy too much. They have a nice little fountain over here. Let's check that out. Nice little relaxing stroll around here, really. It's almost deserted. Everybody's at the park. Really nice and peaceful. That's that recreation center. We'll check that out. And you can see again the wheel, or as I and most people know it, the Orlando Eye. There's a nice green area over here. Really neat. All these old oak trees here, almost like an oak plantation feel to it. Really cool. And again, the neat thing about this is how huge it is and how close it is to everything, because you can just see beyond those trees there. If I zoom just a little bit, you can see businesses just right over there, but it doesn't feel like you're that close to everything. I believe that's like Red Robin right there. So you can see from the paint on the building. All right, we're gonna head back over here and check out this health and fitness center. And then we'll stroll the grounds a little bit. You definitely wanna stay tuned for that, because there's some really cool lagoons and places here. I mean, you can even see right here just how beautiful it is from this vantage point. Several palm trees and these fountains, really awesome. Again, you can see the smaller of the two pools here. But let's go in here and check out what's over here in this area. Here's front desk area. And you can see, wow, this is a really, really big workout area. Wow. A lot of treadmills and steppers and bikes and all kinds of different things. Really nice. And they've got some weight machines over here as well. Pretty much anything you'd need to keep yourself in shape during your vacation. And they've got some of the machines marked as not in use because of social distancing, which is a good idea. That was a really nice little health club fitness center there. And nice that it's not busy during the day either. You can see some of the great, very lush landscaping around here. Once we get out of the pool area, I can do a little bit longer clips here, but still a really nice stroll. And every room has either a patio or a balcony, which is really, really nice. We're gonna do a separate video to show our room. We got a first floor room, and it actually is in this building right here. I think I actually just passed it. Oh yeah, there it is, right there. The one with the window open. That's cool. A helicopter. They do scenic tours with helicopters here. I haven't heard one coming overhead, but I don't think they're very busy. But anyway, I meant to say curtains earlier. I got the curtains open on my room. So again, there's the main pool. Really big, nice main pool area. It's getting more busy. People are hanging out at the resort. So here, these really wonderful grounds of the resort. Got these beautiful lagoons here. Look at this. Really, really nice. It looks like there may have been a fountain in there at one point, but still cool. Look, bananas that you don't often see. It's part of the landscaping. You see banana trees, but I don't usually see bananas on them, so I'm not sure what causes that, but it's definitely nice. Got this nice little bridge to walk over here. Huge lagoon there as well. Of course, no swimming in the lagoons, not that you'd want to. They don't keep them clean or sanitized for swimming at all, so that's important to remember, of course. There's a little waterfall over here. These pathways are really, really well landscaped. And again, you've got a lagoon on the other side as well. So there's just two-story buildings here, but they're all spread out nicely. And the entry to the rooms is inside, which a lot of people like, that the door to your individual rooms is not outside. Makes it a little bit quieter sometimes and just seems safer. The buildings are all locked, by the way, all day, so you have to have a room key to get into any of the buildings. So that's nice for security. There's a little dog cleanup area. So probably shouldn't get too close to that just in case. But right, we're gonna head back around the other side. And some of these banana trees here. Always like good landscaping, and I really appreciate the efforts to keep that up, even though I'm sure business is not as good as normal. But obviously, if you ever do get the chance to come down here, definitely want to come check this resort out. And I wanted to mention also that Wyndham did invite us out here and allow us to stay for two nights to check out the resort, so we could share it with you guys. So big thank you to Wyndham for hosting us here and allowing us to stay. Oh, there's the ducks. They're not Disney ducks, but they're still pretty cool. Hey guys, I won't bother you, don't worry. There they go. I bet they like these lagoons. Four of them, five of them, oh my goodness. They seem to have disturbed them. Sorry guys. Post in the comments, what do you call a group of ducks? I can't remember, I'll have to look that up. All right, well, let's walk over here to this side of the resort. It's pretty similar landscaping, but it's just neat how far these landscapes and pleasant little pathways go. So when you're walking down to the pool or the main lobby or wherever it is that you're going, you've got these really nice areas to walk through. It's not like you're just walking through the parking lot or something. It's really well done and well taken care of. You can see the lagoon rules there. No feeding the wildlife, no swimming, no diving, no wading. Common sense stuff, but I'm glad they remind people. It's a nice reflection. And a little gazebo over there we have to go check out. And you're gonna see the live stream before you see this video, but I wanted to make a standalone video in high quality 4K, where I was just giving you a tour and not reading chat or anything, and just showing you this amazing place. Got some crotons in there, that's nice. I don't know all the plants, but I know those, so we have those. You can hear people in the pool, but otherwise it's pretty quiet around here. It was quiet last night too. That was one thing I was gonna report on, but it was quiet last night. I didn't start hearing people until it was time to have people start going to the parks. And then of course you hear people getting ready and getting up and getting out the rooms and stuff like that. But so here you go. Nice little gazebo just to relax with a really great view. That's not peaceful with the birds chirping. I don't know what is. You've even got a view of the attractions over here, which is cool. You can just barely see the wheel moving there on the left. And of course, you know, we cover mostly Disney, but it is cool to check out these places off property because it's neat to try different things. And of course we all have our favorite Disney resort, but this resort has a lot to offer and it's close to a lot of different attractions. So, you know, if you ever get to take that dream vacation down here where you get to do several different things, or if you want to head over to Universal and you don't want to stay at a Universal resort, you know, this is really great and it's very reasonably priced too. The cool thing is too, there's so much here, you don't have to cross any street to get to. Like there's a Wawa right there. So here you got this Oasis and then a Wawa. So if you need, you know, you could literally walk from your room. You need to go get milk or something for the morning breakfast, or you need to go get a Coke or whatever else. There you go. Is that Star Flyer? Zoom just a little bit so you can see it better. I don't think I'm going to do that. It would be fun, but I would totally drop the gimbal. I'd have to do it gimbal-less. Let's head over here and check out the landscaping on this side. The resort. It's all very similar, but slight variations on the plants and kind of the shape of the lagoons themselves. So, overall, definitely highly recommend this. Because of this experience, I'm kind of excited to get out and about a little more and explore more of Orlando. Orlando is such an amazing place. It has so much to offer. By the way, this is where we started over here. Isn't that crazy? We've almost come full circle. But there's that lobby and convention center. So we pretty much covered it all. But like I said, it's just, you know, it's important, I think. We've been coming to Disney for years, and I know several of you have too, but there's a lot of things in Orlando to check out. We're going to start doing more of that. Don't worry. Disney will always be our home and our main focus, but There's so much here. And again, if you look at the website, I'm going to leave a link in the description. You can get 20% off your booking here at the Wyndham Orlando Resort here on International Drive. You can get 20% off if you just use our link. So already really, really nice prices, but even cheaper if you use our special link. So definitely go check that out, because you could save some money when you come down and still be close to everything. You'd need to have a car. That's the one thing. They don't have transportation to a lot of places here. And you could use an Uber or Lyft as well, if you don't mind doing that. There's the two icons again around the main pool area. So that's pretty cool. And we are back over here at the Gators Bar. We're gonna head back over here by one of the lagoons and wrap this up. It's been a lot of fun taking you around this awesome resort here. I actually think I'm gonna go back over and eat at that restaurant over there and try it out. So I'll let you know on the live stream how that is. Heading back by my room. Kind of wish I'd left the back door open. I could have gone right in. So let's check out the bathroom real quick. These rooms, I think, have been renovated within the last, I'd say, maybe 10 years or so, because they do look updated. The bathroom fixtures are fairly modern and everything. You'll have to excuse any mess you see. I tried to clean up, but they only do the rooms, just like at most of the Disney resorts. They only do them every other day. So this is my last day in the room, so I just wanted to get a good tour. But anyway, so you see, you got nice shower. I always like that they have the curtain rod there that bows out, so you have more room when you're in the shower, which is nice. So just pretty standard bathroom. Carpet is kind of cool, actually. This has got a neat little pattern. And then over here is a closet. These bright red doors. You've got an iron suitcase rack. There's even a safe down there. We did the live stream. A lot of people wanted to know if there was a safe, and there is. I've got my bags in here just to kind of tidy up a little bit. And of course, some hangers and a lot of places to put your stuff. So if you've got a big family with a lot of stuff, there is a lot of room in here. There's even room, I believe, for a rollaway over here if you needed to have that. We always had to have a rollaway because we had a family of five. So, and we've got two double beds here. And they're not queens, they are double, but you know, it works for a couple nights if you've got a big family. You kind of do get used to that. So, and the beds are comfortable. They are actually pillow top. So when you push on it, you can kind of feel that it is nice and soft. You're not sleeping right on the springs like you do at some cheaper places. And the pricing on these rooms runs from about $100 to $150 a night, depending on what kind of room you get. This is the premium, so it's probably closer to $150. But if you use the link we've got in the description, you can get 20% off. So definitely take advantage of that. Got some nice artwork there on the wall. It's really cool. And again, everything's pretty modern. It looks like it's updated, the furniture there and everything. Now, one thing is, the chargers here, they're just regular wall outlets, so definitely bring your wall plugs. There's no USB. I do wish there were USB, but at the same time, you do go to hotels that have those USBs and they charge really slow and you end up using the plugs anyway. So not too big of an issue. Just make sure you bring all your cords. And you've got a little desk over here. Got my breakfast cereal there, and coffee maker, ice bucket, decent TV. The TV actually has a cable, Spectrum cable, and there's a TV guide on it as well, so that's always nice. You can actually see what's on. And there is a mini fridge, which is important because you can grab some milk for breakfast or soft drinks or whatever else you'd like to put in there. And they actually gave us some wine. I had Jenna go ahead and take it home, but just for us staying here, we appreciate that. And we do appreciate Wyndham inviting us out here and hosting us today for this weekend stay. Now, one of the things is, and this is a nice little chair to kind of just relax in, The reason this is a premium room is because of the premium view. You can see it's a beautiful day out today, but you've got a great view of the grounds, which we showed in another video, so definitely go check that out. And you've got a nice little sitting area out here. So you can relax and enjoy a beautiful view. And as I mentioned in the other video, this whole resort is in within walking distance of Icon Park and several other attractions along International Drive here, including Ripley's Believe It or Not, Madame Tussauds, all kinds of different things. The other thing I mentioned on the live stream is I like the security here. They've got the security bar, so you definitely, even though you're on the first floor, you've got the sliding door, you definitely feel safe because this bar is here. It would definitely stop anybody from trying to come in, but and they even tell you, remind you to lock the door and put the security bar in place. So that's basically it. But that's what you're doing is, you know, you're paying a little extra for the view. Now, if you don't care about the view, you know, you also can just go ahead and get the standard room, which is closer to about $100. And, you know, if you're just sleeping in the room and going to the theme parks, nothing wrong with that. You may not really need the view anyway. So that's totally your decision as you book the room, but definitely use that link to get 20% off. Will definitely help. I feel like I'm on lap two here, but I don't think you'll mind. This is kind of a nice stroll here. Really, really nice place to just relax. And I do want to say, you know, that we're being hosted our first couple times here for some of these things, the Disney Media event and this, but please remember, we will always be honest with you. If we don't like something, I'm showing you what this resort looks like. And like I said, you know, not everything's open right now. They don't serve breakfast, things like that, but that's to be expected with all the craziness with COVID going on. So I'm really enjoying my stay here so far. And I do want to give you my honest opinion. If there was anything wrong, that's, you know, the breakfast, no breakfast was the only thing, but I can totally understand that. There's the ducks having a great time over here. But it was easy enough, you know, as far as the breakfast thing goes, it was way easy just to go over to Walgreens and Wawa and grab something, and it was faster anyway. There are also tons of restaurants around here, Perkins and several other places that you can walk down to. McDonald's not too far away if you want to go get something, you know, a little bit more substantial than just getting cereal or something. So thanks for joining me on this relaxing stroll and tour of the Wyndham Orlando Resort here on International Drive. Again, thanks to Wyndham for inviting us out here today. We really appreciate it. We've really enjoyed it. Definitely be sure to check out our sponsors as well, MickeyBlog.com and MickeyTravels.com, for the best in free Disney vacation planning advice. Also, be sure to check out Victor Naraki. If you're thinking about moving to Central Florida, he can help you do that. Go to DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com or CelebratingFlorida.com. Also, go follow him on Facebook, Facebook.com/NarakiRealtor. And again, if you want to book a room here at Wyndham, use our code. There's a link in the description. Go down to the description box, check out the link, and book your room here. So we appreciate you guys watching the video. Appreciate them having us out. And that's about all for now. So for now, have a great, big, beautiful tomorrow. Bye-bye. Now that you've finished watching this video, be sure that you're subscribed so that you can get all of the latest updates. Also, check out some other great videos on our channel. Have a great, big, beautiful tomorrow. Bye-bye.